Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Mashofsky Lumber Company, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thanks, Todd. It was a good way to start the season, obviously.
I know going into the game, obviously, a lot of uncertainties, concerns. You have new people playing here and there. I think overall, I think you have to be really satisfied with not only the victory and how it was accomplished, but I thought your team showed tremendous poise and character and really did the right things at the right time in this ballgame.
Well, we made a lot of mistakes, Todd, but obviously there were some situations that we needed to do a little bit better and to improve on, and I'm sure we will. There were some new people playing for the first time in the Pac-10 that I thought did a very creditable job in their first performance. And the one thing, as you mentioned, that I was most pleased about was the poise that our team showed. We talked about it before the game, that there were going to be some bad moments in the game, some things that didn't go our way, and that we would overcome them, that we would respond, and somebody would make a good play on offense, defense, or the kicking game to make up for whatever mistakes we made. We made some. Cal made a lot more, I might add. And we took advantage of their mistakes, and we overcame the ones that we were making.
Offensively, there was concern this fall because of the way your defense and scrimmages had dominated your offense. Were you more than pleased with the offensive performance yesterday?
Well, I've got to be pleased with our offensive performance. We had a very good balance. We ran the ball effectively, which I think is a pretty good defensive unit from Cal. I think they're very physical up front. They have good quickness. And I was a little bit surprised that we ran the ball as effectively and as consistently as we did against Cal. The protection was good. Musgrave was hurried a lot, but never sacked. We had the turnover on the fumble, which was not good, but no interceptions. And we really had a very minimal penalty yardage as well. We only had 4 penalties. I think Cal was penalized 10 times, very costly. I was pleased with the offensive unit. The point production was fine, the yardage, time of possession, some critical drives into the wind that we needed to move the ball, we accomplished that.
Temperature got up to about 90 degrees, one of the warmest days, maybe the warmest day in the Eugene Springfield area. Coach, your thoughts about the heat and the factor it took in the game?
The heat was definitely a factor. We usually have a week or so of that kind of heat. Here's the opening kickoff during fall camp. Oldham almost broke that. Chris was one step away from having a long return there. 24 yards right out of the barrel, so we at least get out of the shadow of our own end zone. And we open up with a belly play straight ahead, and Lattenberry muscles ahead for 6 yards.
Ball now at the 31-yard line. Good balance here, Coach, with the running game, with Lattenberry and, of course, Derek Lavelle.
Crash sweep here. Just short of the first down, about a yard and a half to go now. Good run by Lavelle.
This is a first and 10 play after you picked up the first down on third down.
Nice pass there, Joe Merton. It's nice to have the tight end. I think our tight end's got 6 passes, and that's been missing from our offense from a couple of years. Coach Pilates done a good job of integrating the tight end back into our offense. Nice block there by Sunia, and a nice cut by Lavelle to break it outside for a very nice gain right in front of the Cal bench.
It's a big play here, and this is kind of typical of what happened during the course of the afternoon. You're forced to punt, but Cal makes some kind of a mistake and gets ruled for an infraction, this time running into Mark Penso. Now, what a way to break into the conference of your first punt and you get knocked in your wallet.
Good first snap, first punt. It went out of bounds on the 11 if it was, if it hadn't been roughing, but they made a critical penalty, roughed the kicker, and we come back, and Lavelle makes a great cut to the sideline. Now we run into the boundary. Not much there, but just an amazing job. I was right there, and he did a great job of just walking down that sideline and keeping his feet in bounds with half of his shoulders leaning over the out of bounds, and picked up the first down. Now on a rollout pass, Musgrave kind of sidearms it underneath the rush, and Hargain goes up and makes a great catch. Hargain dropped the first pass of the game, came back and made a great catch there. You can see Musgrave come out here. We don't do a good job blocking the Odom, the linebacker, and Musgrave fires it underneath his arms, And Hargain goes up and makes a nice grab. Looks like he went kind of going up for a rebound, huh?
That's right,
floor.
In basketball. I thought that was a real confidence booster, not only for your team, but for Tony Hargain. I think he needed that catch.
Yeah, it was good. And here we get, we got to educate our fans. We're calling an audible there. The backs could not hear the audible, so we need to, our fans to be quiet when we have the ball, particularly down near the goal line, and make a lot of noise when the other team has it.
And they can make a lot of noise right about here, too. That's okay.
That's okay. That's okay. Great drop back pass here. Cal played a lot of zone, and we, rather than sprint out a lot down here, we decided to go back and try to split the seams of the zone. And you can see that Hargain does a good job. Musgrave sees him here. They're playing man underneath on this one. And Hargain just runs a nice route and easy catch in the end zone for the opening TD.
So the Ducks, with their first drive of the ball game, go 75 yards in 15 plays. The extra point snap bad, no good. So the Ducks lead it 6-0.
Dave Cassano snapping for the first time in his career as a senior, the most accurate and consistent one we had all fall camp, and he let one skid under there, and he was perfect the rest of the day. So we got rid of the jitters out of him now, and we're going to have great snapping all year long.
Special teams, Brandon Jumper had a couple of big hits on the kickoffs.
I'll tell you, Brandon Jumper is a good football player. He's a very good football player, and he made some key plays for us blocking as well as on the special teams.
You stop Cal on its first possession, you get the football back, mounting another drive.
Same play we opened the game with, the belly play. Latin picks up about 7 yards, made a nice cut there. Here Musgrave comes out on the sprint out, throws deep, and Hargain again. Nice catch, goes up and out, battles the corner for Cal, and comes down with the football.
Pickup of 33 yards.
See, good protection here. We're in a unbalanced line. We block down with the tight end because he's covered and not eligible. And Musgrave throws it up into the wind, I might add, and throws it nice, and Hargain goes up and comes down with the ball.
You really had some people make key plays, athletic plays, during the course of the ballgame. We'll see Joe Reitzik later on. McCallum, 45 field goal attempt is good with distance to spare.
And that's into the wind. That's a very impressive kick. I think a real confidence builder for him and for us as coaches is to judge where he's going to have a chance to kick him from. This is a major breakdown in the kicking game. We kicked off deep and the wind held it up, and we had a breakdown in our coverage, and Chris Oldham does a good job coming back here and saving the touchdown, but we gave up unbelievable field position here, and those are the type of things that we can't have happen. In the future, we must stop that kind of play from existing in our kicking game.
I thought that kickoff return sparked Cal. They were a little lethargic, and this gave them some life. And eventually, they get the ball into the end zone on this drive. Took them a couple of plays to do it. But Taylor to Jenkins gets 11, and then Taylor straight back to pass. Just inside the end line.
Boy, that was close. I mean, I put it on our slow-mo this morning, and that... I'm not sure he had total possession of that ball because his one foot is coming off the ground while the other one's on the white stripe as he catches the ball, and that's it's a judgment call, but it was real close.
So 9-7, and the first quarter, a little more offense than a lot of people expected in this ball game. Cal gets the football back on the last possession of the first quarter. Taylor picks up 12 on the pass to Wallace. That's that little delay that you were talking about.
We did a much better job in the second half. We were taking too deep of drops, and Joe Farwell was dropping out of there a little too deep initially. They run, this is the only real running play they broke for any yardage. Darrell Reed played an outstanding, the ground caused that fumble. There's no question that was down. Darrell Reed played very, very well in this football game.
Taylor again, on into the flat, Ford.
And Steve Kemp in our Hawk package, knocking him out of bounds.
So that was the final play that we will see in the first quarter. Entering the second quarter, the Ducks are leading Cal 9-7, so let's pick up action in the second quarter. California has the football, trying to mount a drive and trying to take the lead with a field goal or a touchdown, but the Ducks won't let it happen. Taylor trying to scramble, and you see he does get out of the pocket, puts his head down, picks up a couple.
Good coverage downfield and good pressure. I think Matt Labonte comes up with the tackle on that play. Counter play here, and well contained on the outside. Good job there by Mark Kearns, and makes a tackle for loss. You can see Kearns from his inside linebacking position. Brantley stuffs it inside, forces the play wide. Kearns is out there, goes to his knees, but still is able to make the tackle for about a 3-yard loss.
So let's call it the second down and long. Taylor. Little dump over the middle. Good defense here. Rory Deary, Joe Farwell, was right there on the play.
Same one they've been gaining a lot of yards on, and Joe finally figured out he shouldn't be dropping out there into the stands, and he came back and made a nice play on that. Taylor scrambles here. Calman makes a nice catch, but he leaps and never comes down except until he's after he's about 3 yards out of bounds.
And here's Cal's All-American field goal kicker. Was 22 of 25 a year ago, and he just shanked that one badly.
The wind was very, very difficult, and that's why the 45-yarder was extremely impressive by McCallum earlier going into the wind, and then, as you see, Keene missed a shorter one there, but the wind blew out of there. Nice pass here to Lattenberry out in the flat. Picks up about 5.
Just underway in the second quarter. Ducks leading it 9-7.
And a good power play up inside. Two tight ends. Lattenberry leading the charge up inside, and we pick up a first down.
Good blocking by Brian Hannibal there, that left guard on the play. Lattenberry, boy, just a tough inside runner. We'll hear from he and Derek Lavelle at halftime.
A good cross trap play there, and come back with a blast again, and Lavelle. You know, I mean, those aren't pretty plays for the fans, but I want to tell you, they go a long way in establishing the tempo of the game and what you're able to do with your other plays, and takes the pressure off your pass protection. Jeff Thomason, remember, played last year as a true freshman, had a pretty impressive game in his first game this fall. Play action pass up inside. Thomason, we're in a two tight end, what we call our ace formation, and Thomason, who's the left tight end, slips out in the flat, and the flow sucks the secondary over here. Looking back into the sun, running backwards, he almost fair caught Musgrave's pass. No, he
personal foul. I assume is for spearing on the defensive back there.
For spearing.
Drive kind of bogs down. McCallum comes in from 37 yards in that crosswind, and he nails it through, and the Ducks lead it 12-7.
Big kick there, because it would have been very disappointing not to come away with points in that particular situation.
So Cal now gets the football back midway through the second quarter. Taylor between the two defensive backs, Horton and Oldham. Big gain for Cal of 27.
One of the very few times Taylor was able to throw the ball down the field. We didn't do a good job frictioning him, and Oldham will come back and intercept a pass similar to that. Good job here by Mark Kern scraping off and getting a sack on Troy Taylor. You can see from the bottom of your screen, Brantley comes in, forces Taylor wide, takes out the blocker, and Kearns immediately scrapes right off and makes a fine play to sack Taylor.
Loss of 7 on the play. Second down and 17. Cal now comes back with a little screen pass. And they break it big.
We did a very bad job out there on the perimeter and a poor job of tackling. Derek's got a instead of roping him and trying to ride him down, he's got to knock him down.
And a couple of plays later,
same exact pattern that they got their first touchdown. And we didn't do a very good job covering it the second time as we did the first time.
So now one of several two-point conversion tries. Since Cal is ahead by 1, they want to go up by 3. But Taylor in trouble. And really good defensive coverage by the ball.
It was good coverage, good containment, good pressure. Made him force the decision quickly.
Each team had another possession before we pick up action again. Neither able to move it. So now, with 1:37 left to go in the first half, the Ducks get one final opportunity to get some points on the board. And Mr. Berry takes control.
Cal leading at this point. Good job here on the draw play. You can see an excellent cut there by Latin. And he takes it up the field, running hard. Makes a nice gain and a first down.
So the ball now is out to the 37-yard line, 1:17 to play after an incomplete pass. This is a second down and 10.
Excellent job here on the screen pass. Lavelle comes across in motion, makes it look like it's a pass front side, and Latin makes a cut here. He loses sight of the guy behind him and almost gets the ball stripped out there, but a very, very big play just before the end of the half. You can see Lavelle coming in motion. We sprint this way. Berry comes this way. He slips out the backside. They're in man-to-man coverage. Andy Sunia and Scott Boatwright out in front. Sunia gets a nice block right here. Boom. Gets the guy down. Latin shakes the tackle. Good effort down there by Boatwright. And Latin makes a nice cut right here to get, not much of a tackle there. And He gets pulled down on the 5-yard line. He had two long runs, one off a pass, one off a run. He didn't get in the end zone on either one, and he fumbled on one of them. And we've talked about that already, him looking back all the way.
Well, he's not used to being out in the open like that.
Well, that's what he told me, Thomas. Nice play here, run fake inside after running one play. We come off with a fake inside by Musgrave to the back. Lavelle made a nice diving fake, and Thomason slipped out and was wide open. You can watch jumper in there for the blast play. Up and over, Lavelle jumps up in the air. We get a good block by Sunia, and Thomason makes a nice catch of a softly thrown Musgrave pass in the corner.
So a very impressive drive near the end of the half. 77 yards on 5 plays. You go for 2.
We go for 2, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage.
A year ago, Coach, they had the rule where if you returned a missed conversion, you could get a couple of points.
That's still in effect, and I think with the no kicking tee, you might even see it come into play this year.
All right, at halftime, the Ducks, on the basis of that late drive, are leading the Cal Bears 18-13. Well, the Ducks will be kicking off to start the third period of play as Cal will have the football and the wind. But the Ducks have the lead 18-13.
We elected to kick off into the wind in the third quarter so we'd have it in the fourth quarter, and the decision turned out to be good here as Farwell makes a real nice play on the swing or screen pass out to the side and actually makes a tackle for an 8-yard loss. You can see this again on the replay. Coming from the bottom, good coverage downfield. They're trying to draw us out here. Farwell slips the block there, comes back, and makes a nice tackle for a loss.
And as you can see, a good line of sight there on the down camera. That was a lateral. If he had not caught the ball, it would have been a free ball.
Great interception here by Chris Oldham. Just a fantastic laid out in the air. You can't see it. He's not quite on the bottom of your screen. You'll see him after he's been in the air for probably about 5 yards, and he comes down with the football, a great interception, and really one of the most disappointing things in the game now follows. We are unable to move the football here, and we have to punt it away after a sudden change opportunity with great field position.
So Cal gets it back.
Darrell Reed, again, as I mentioned earlier, played an outstanding game. Quick pass out there, a little quick screen out in the flat. He gets there before anybody can get out to block him and makes a tackle for a loss. Outstanding play.
So Cal, again, forced to punt. The Ducks take over at their own 25. Big play right off the bat.
It's a third down play. Lattenberry keeps looking. See him looking back. I told him, you know, Latten, you can't run very fast when you look back. And you can see here that the ball is out before it hits the ground. Fans could not see that, and they were relatively upset. But a good trap block by Andy Sunia. Pop it clean into the secondary. Latten makes a nice move there, but now just put your head toward the goal line and run like the devil. Keeps looking back, and he's come off of a hamstring injury. He just started practicing about 6 days ago again, but you can see the ball gets stripped out. It's rolling in play, and Cal does recover.
So Cal gets the football, but you thought this next series maybe was the key to the game.
Well, the fans got fired up because they didn't think it was really a fumble. And it fired our defense up. Should have been, I thought, offensive pass interference right there. That even got the fans more upset, got our team more upset. Roy Derry was in great position, and I think would have intercepted the ball, except the Cal receiver came over his back. Excellent. Now you can see a little more aggression on the part of the defense. Derek Horton comes up and makes a tackle along with Mark Kearns. See this on the ground level again. Nice play here. Come up. Derek Horton, bang, right there. Gets help from Mark Kearns and finish it off. And we get a little bit more fired up on the defensive side of the ball, a little more aggressive. Roy Derry running through coverage here with the man in motion. More pressure on the quarterback now, has to throw it quick. Kearns is there, incomplete.
So good defensive series, the sudden change that I know you work on a lot. The crowd, as you can see, is fired up, and the Ducks get the football back. And this really is a key drive right here in the football game.
A waggle pass and a little dump is tipped, but Lattenberry makes the catch and picks up 12 yards on first down.
So we'll look at it again.
Fake coming back this way to Lavelle. He makes a key block there. Comes out, Musgrave has a lot of time, but the coverage is pretty good, so Musgrave just tries to float it over, but it does get tipped. Latten makes a nice catch, sidesteps a tackler there, and powers forward past the first down marker for an extra 3 yards.
First and 10 at the Cal 36.
Musgrave throws a swing pass out again to Lattenberry, and he picks up a nice gain before being knocked out of bounds and getting an additional tacked on 5 yards for face mask.
Lattenberry had a tremendous day, a career high 151 yards rushing. Also caught a couple of passes. He was really involved in almost half of the offensive yardage.
Another big mistake here by Cal. Pass interference. Musgrave did a great job just getting the ball off before he got killed there. Here, bad play. We mishandled the pitch. We lose a great opportunity to take it in for a touch and have to come back here now on make a great play on third down to Joe Reitzig. Unbelievable catch in the end zone. I'd rather not have to make a living on getting touchdowns on third and 20.
But it is good for the score, and that is our play of the game.
You can see Musgrave drop back here. We've got four receivers in the game. Excellent pass protection. He throws it up. It's covered well, but Reitzig just jumps up and makes the play.
We'll take a look at that in a minute once again. It's one of those ones where you diagram, you want to do certain things, but it all comes down to somebody making an athletic play.
Well, what we do in that situation, Todd, we have four receivers in the game and only one back. Latin stayed in at the fullback. We dropped straight back, and we ran crossing routes on this side, and the outside receiver breaks into the inside here. Reitzig breaks out, hoping to lose his man and go to the back part of the end zone, and we want to try to get a four-way vertical stretch on him. We assumed that they would be playing zone down here. Reitzig was covered well. He just made an unbelievable athletic play, as you saw, right in the back of the end zone. Got 1 foot down. Very similar to a catch he made at Washington State a year ago for a great touchdown up there.
All right, let's take another look at that play. Joe Reitzig on the receiving end of the touchdown.
Reitzig coming out, number six, breaks to the outside at the top of your screen. You'll come back in. You'll see the Cal defender has great position on him, but Reitzig goes up, leaps, gets his foot down. Unbelievable.
That really was a great catch, and Joe Reitzig is capable of those kind of catches. And that's a big score for the Ducks, because now the crowd is really into the football game. The point after by McCallum is good, and you have a 12-point lead, 25-13. The Ducks have added a field goal, and it's 28-13 with about 8 minutes to play in the football game. Cal has the football back, trying to mount a drive to get back in the game. The Ducks on defense, the first play we will see. Taylor back to pass, and from the top of the screen, Matt LeBounty with the sack, fumble, but Cal recovers.
Excellent job by LeBounty coming off the corner, getting great pressure. You can see on the replay here, he actually arm under on the tackle at the top of your screen. I believe he's being held a little bit, but he fights out of the hold, blindsides Taylor. The ball comes out. Unfortunately, it bounces to a Cal lineman. There's still a scramble for the ball, but Cal comes up with it.
So a loss of six on the play. This is a third down and five for Cal.
Sprint out by Taylor. Throws. This is one of our misaligned plays here. Nice tackle by Chris Olin. We didn't even cover the guy. Nobody covered him. And Chris came off of the man he had and fortunately made the play. They eventually take this in for the touchdown, but at least we... Nice play there by Roy Derry, but at least we made him use up more of the clock.
Second down and 10 play coming up here. Taylor.
Good pressure here. He dumps it off as he's being tackled. We miss a tackle, and he's down to the 1 yard line.
He did stop them on first down, which ran off a little time on the clock. This is a second down play. Zumwalt gets in.
It was a good shot there on him, but he powered in. He's a freshman, true freshman running back, and he does have some power. 2-point play, conversion attempt here. Taylor scrambling, throws it, incomplete.
Big play, because if the 2-point conversion had been successful, Cal would have been within a touchdown and an extra point of tying. Now they need two scores, and one has to be a touchdown. Onside kick time. This is, I think, about the second or third time
attempt.
They tried it.
Goes off of Kolya Teft, and although it didn't go the necessary 10 yards, I'm not sure the Cal player didn't touch it just before.
I think he did. We've got a low replay, coach.
Ground level replay here. You can see the ball, and you can't tell, but I believe the Cal toucher player touched it before it went to 10 yards. Then it hit Kolya Teft, went off his chest, and they recovered it. Big play by Cal, obviously, something that we're going to have to work on. We need to make sure that we handle onside kicks.
So Cal gets the football back. Remember, they're trailing in the game. by 9, 28-19. Good pressure on Taylor, and he's just swarmed. About 7 Duck jerseys there to make the stop.
Excellent coverage downfield that allowed us to trap Taylor in the pocket. Blindside shot by Peter Brantley. Nice to have him back. He missed. Well, I'm sorry, that's Bjarne Jensen.
For good to have him back, too.
Well, it is good to have him back. You can see BJ coming from the bottom of your screen. Nobody picks him up, and bingo, right in the blind side, and the ball comes out, but forced by the ground, and the ground cannot force a fumble.
So it's third down and 17. 4.5 minutes to play in the game.
Little dump pass underneath. Chris Oldham again. Seems like he was everywhere on the field.
So fourth and 6. Clock is continuing to roll. Taylor dump pass. No good. Kearns.
Good pressure by LeBounty and nice coverage by Kearns.
So now you're in a situation where if the offense can just get a first down, run off some time on the clock, you've got this one wrapped up. But the offense couldn't. Penso has to punt it. And he was roughed on the play, I believe, Coach. But yet at the other end, Oldham not only forces the turnover, he actually recovers the fumble.
Well, they kind of shot themselves in the foot both sides. They roughed the kicker, which meant we'd have kept the ball. Oldham stripped it out. We recovered the fumble. And now we're just going to run out the clock by running straight blast plays. Good job, Brandon Jumper leading the charge in there, and Derek LaBelle taking it up inside.
You said these were the plays you called.
That's right. We're great imagination here, right? No, we didn't want to just kill the clock. You never know what can happen in a game. So we just decided to run the ball and try to get a first down, and ended up obviously getting more than a first down.
Remember a couple of years ago, Ron Rivera of Cal stole a ball literally on a running play when you were trying to run out the clock, and actually made the game more interesting than maybe it should have been.
Here's LaBelle with a big effort, leaping up for a touchdown.
So McCallum comes in for the point after, and that will be the final score of the ball game, 35-19. The PAT here is good. We got one more play to show you. The kickoff.
Squib kick, which we did a lot of, particularly into the wind, but again, not wanting them to get a long return, we squibbed this one on the ground for the last kick, and they field it.
And the tackle made by
Brady Brooks.
There you go.
Didn't wrap up on him, but he got him down pretty good with a hit.
There you go. So there is the final score, 35-19.
Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Mashofsky Lumber Company, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.
Family Dentistry.